He said, one of you. And I said last Sunday, the Bible says anything that's not of faith is sin. And the easiest way for Satan to find you an accomplice is that you get out of faith. Yeah. And I give that example. If I'm standing in faith on something, your job is to stand with me.
Amen.
You have to stand with me. You have to believe with me. You have to pray with me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That is true body ministry.
Yeah.
Time out now for you to just come to receive. When things are good for you, I can't tell you anything. But then as soon as you run into what you cannot handle, now you remember that I exist. I keep walking. Serve God with me when you're feeling good. He said, now, one of you shall betray me. Then the disciples looked one on another, doubting of whom he spake. Now there was leaning on Jesus' bosom one of his disciples whom Jesus loved. Simon Peter therefore beckoned to him that he should ask who it should be of whom he spake. He then, lying on Jesus' breast, said unto him, Lord, who is it? You see, you must accept as part of this kingdom that God is not an American. He don't have to do for you what he has done for somebody else. He didn't promise you that. It's preachers that's telling you that. What he's done for others, he will do for you. Who told you that?
Amen.
Do you have the same covenant?
Amen.
Do you have the same level of obedience?
Come on now.
Do you have the same level of commitment?
Amen.
So John could lean on Jesus' breast, but Peter couldn't.
Amen.
If Peter tried that, he'd push him off. John was the apostle of love. And him laying on Jesus' breast is an indication that of all the disciples, this is the one that had my heart the most.
Amen.
He's not known for his activity or his natural wisdom or his fishing or anything. But he was called the apostle of love. And the testimony to show all of us that you cannot walk in hate is that John was thrown into boiling oil and it had no effect because the love of God was so strong in him. Watch now. This is not written in the Bible. This is written in history. By Josephus. Google it. In boiling oil. But the love of God was so strong. That's why the enemy is constantly trying to make you hate.
Amen.
Make you judge. So you will lose your power. And they threw him in that oil. Look at how hateful men are. You know, I mean, if you're cooking something and the thing splashes, it burns you. Then how would you have a heart to throw another human being? In boiling oil. What was their crime? Because they believed in Jesus. That's what America is trying to come to. If y'all keep voting for these liberals, you think they love your God? That's what the hatred is. You're trying to delay the takeover of the Antichrist. And when the man, did not burn, the boiling oil had no effect. They said, well, this is beyond us. And they pulled him out and then took him to the island of Patmos and left him there to die. But it was a setup for his greatest breakthrough. Hey, no, I need to put my iPad down. Did you catch that bullet from heaven? When the enemy's doing me, he's thinking he's about to destroy me. He's setting me up for my greatest breakthrough. They sent him out there to die. And suddenly, that's what I'm telling Seventh-day Adventist folks. That's what I'm telling Sabbatarians. Yes. God said, remember the Sabbath to keep it holy. That's for the Jews. That's not for me. My salvation began Sunday morning. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? When Jesus came out of that grave, hallelujah, woo, he said, all power is given unto me in heaven. Woo. That's when my salvation came. The Bible says in the book of Corinthians 15, 1 Corinthians 15, I don't want to say 1 Corinthians. He said, now, if Christ was not risen from the dead, he said, you are yet in your sins. And all those that died in Christ have perished forever. In other words, Sunday morning was when my salvation began. What am I doing worshiping on Saturday? That's for natural Jews. I'm a wild olive that was supernaturally grafted in into the original vine. I'm shouting because he rose. I'm praising because he took the keys of hell from the devil. Hallelujah. I said, what you talking about? He says, on the Lord's day, meaning Sunday morning. Why didn't they come on Saturday? Because John was a New Testament believer. First thing, Sunday morning, said the angel of the Lord descended. You put me out here to die, and you set me up for God to encounter me. Look at the question he just dropped in my spirit to ask you. Why are you messing up your breakthrough by murmuring about what you should be shouting about as your setup for your next? I say your next breakthrough. What are you waiting on? This is Sunday morning. You are in the house of the Lord. The shout of God is in the room. The angel of the Lord is here. Receive. Look at the instruction. They said to John, you've done good. You kept your faith. You are worshiping. Even though they abandoned you here. But your level is still too low. He said, come up hither. Rise. Ooh, hallelujah. Some of you are sitting smug, thinking you're doing pretty good. But he's telling you this morning, come up. Come up. Come up hither. I have revelations for you. Have a seat, have a seat, so I can hurry on. Are you following what I'm showing you? This is why I told you, you can not only worship God when you're feeling good. You are missing these kinds of supernatural moment. Lord, I don't feel good, but I bless you, hallelujah. I worship you. If you still can speak to me, Lord, go ahead. Let me hear you. Give me instructions to walk through this valley. You are with me. Now watch. He said, ask him who is it? Because we don't know. We don't know who will betray him. And Jesus said, I'm trying to show you something. Watch. There's no shout here, but there's wisdom here. Watch. He said, now, whoever I give this to, I'll take the bread, which is my body, and I will dip it in the wine. And if I give it to any man, That's the man that will betray me. Now, I want to open your eyes. Why is it that he did it to Judas and he did not change his mind? Why is it that no matter what is preached, your mind is not changed? What is that thing that keeps you from moving from your position? See, you have a devil. Because naturally, if Jesus says it were better for you not to have been born than for you to do what you're about to do, and your mind still did not change, that means your mind is stronger than your spirit. That even though your heart is telling you, you know he's talking about you. Judas was so deceived that he joined the question, Lord, is it I? And Jesus says, thou sayest. And yet his mind did not change. I keep asking you, why is it that no matter what is preached, your mind doesn't change? I said, you have a devil.
Amen.
You have a devil. He said, Judas took the sop, boom! He said, Satan entered him. Okay. Now, if this was a pastoral meeting, I would be telling them things totally different from what I'm telling you. But let me borrow a leaf from what I will be telling them. Watch. Jesus did not try to pastor Judas away from doing what he did. Why? He warned him. He corrected him. He saw the miracles. He saw the testimonies. But it still did not change. Because when he joined the group, he came with an agenda. And when Jesus deviated from his agenda, that's what I experienced with the first church. This place was packed. There was no room. People were sitting out in the lobby.
Yes.
Then we opened up the Glory Fellowship. Yeah. But when I started telling them what God was saying, they all emptied out. And one of the ringleaders said, well, you know what he does? He wants to get you into these meetings to get you to think like him. And when you don't think like him, he says you're a rebel. I thought you said that God sent you to me. And my job is to tell you what God.
Amen.
I didn't know that it was your mind against my mind. You see how I can detect who has a devil?
Amen.
The moment I correct you, you stop coming to church. You say you're watching on video. You're not watching anything because your heart is not changed.
Amen.
You have a devil.
Amen.
And the more you come, the sooner you confront it, the more certain your eternal outcome will be.
Amen.
Exchanges. What happens to you when this is given to you? Do you get ministrations from heaven?
Yeah.
Or do demons enter you to make certain that what you think is resolved?
Amen.
Now, don't run. Because anytime I mention anything sexual, you all take off running. One of the things God told me to teach married folks, he said, stop using sex to resolve differences.
Amen.
And arguments. Amen. You know, you fight with each other, then you jump in the bed and have sex.
Amen.
He said, you have to know when the issues are not resolved, when you have sex, the issues go deeper into your spirit,
yeah,
into your soul. And now what was a little issue becomes a stronghold. God was teaching me these things years ago. He said, so when the relationship is not right, he said, withdraw yourself from this because you're going to obtain things you don't know where they came from. Because when somebody you engage with is impregnated with devils, you open up yourself for attacks.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I told you there'll be no shouting in this dimension. One minister in my old church came to me. He said, "Pastor Chica, what are you doing in my bedroom?" And I was wondering, I don't know where your bedroom is. I haven't been in it. He said, "Now, it was time for action." And I was messing with my wife. And she said to me, "Pastor Chica said that sex is only 25% of a marriage. We have more important things to discuss before we get to this." He said, "What are you doing in my bedroom? Take your sermon with you." Lord, what haven't I endured? I was teaching people what God taught me.
Amen.
They were not interested.
Amen.
They got their certificate. Eh? First of all, don't you see that marriage is the only thing you go into before you take the test? They give you the certificate. Every other thing, you have to take the exam and pass it.
Amen.
This one, they give you the certificate. So you have to go to God to learn how to pass it. But you are rejoicing in the fact that you have your certificate finally. That you are not interested in what God is teaching you.
Come on now.
This solemn assembly I just produced tells me that I need to hang here for the rest of the service. Watch. He said, one of you. So I encourage you, when you receive this, make sure that Satan doesn't enter you.
Yeah.
Next Sunday, I will show you what you need to do so Satan will not enter you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
That this will be a miracle to you.
Amen.
Breakthrough for you.
Amen.
Change for you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come on. So, if God is correcting you, don't ignore him. Pray right now where you are seated. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. We ask you to forgive us known and unknown sins. That we may be worthy to receive your body and your blood. Oh, Lord. By the blood of Jesus, make us worthy that we might receive in truth and receive a blessing and not a curse. Thank you for it now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. There was a huge debate in the 80s. Can a Christian have a demon? You remember that?
Yes.
And I don't know who said it. After all the debate, he said, "Now a Christian can have whatever they want." God renewed your spirit man at salvation.
Yes.
But whatever you open your soul to will influence you.
Yes.
A Christian cannot be possessed.
Amen.
But demons can manipulate you through your soul to do anything.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, if I said, now, if your mind cannot be changed, you have a devil, and I felt an offense, go through the congregation. Sorry, I didn't write it. You notice? You have to use the word of God as a mirror to see yourself.
Yeah.
What is this thing that empowers you where you can hold on to your opinion? No matter what is preached, no matter what is taught, no matter what is counseled, and your mind refuses to change.
Amen.
There's somebody helping you.
Amen.
I don't know why the people that walked out. But if that was the offense, I can't apologize. I'm reading it to you out of the book. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God that you have somebody who can see these things in the scriptures. Yeah. Because he said even the scripture has no private interpretation. It has to mean the same thing to all of us all around the world. That's what I'm telling Americans. They're not going to have a special American line. Okay, this is true except you're an American. We all are going to take the same test.
Amen.
And it's an open book test.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So celebrate this morning. As I said in my message, this is Sunday morning.
Hallelujah.
This is the Lord's day.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord is here. Father, we receive the body and the blood of the Lord Jesus. We believe for deliverance and no demonic influence. May this altar give us life, give us a breakthrough, give us deliverance. We thank you for it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. Receive it now in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup. When he had stopped saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Celebrate that the new covenant is in the blood.
Hallelujah.
Not in your actions, but in the blood.
Hallelujah.
Drink it now in remembrance of Jesus. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup.
Yeah.
You do show the Lord's death till he come.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know every time I turn around, there's something that just keeps drawing me to you, but I don't know what it is. Eh? I'll just throw my cup on you. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Listen. You've lifted some burdens from me lately with all that you've been working with. I bless you in Jesus' name. The Bible speaks about receiving the body and the blood of the Lord unworthily. If you paid attention to the stories I was sharing on this broadcast, you see that many of God's people are users. You mistreat people. You use people. And then as soon as you get on your feet, you forget the people that helped you. You are so full of pride. Some of you have gone to school and your degree is more important than your salvation. Some of you have gotten breakthroughs financially and your economic status becomes a source of pride. I can tell you on the authority of the Word of God, if your salvation, the saving of your soul by the grace of God, is not the greatest thing that God has ever done for you, then eternal life will be in question. You will put all these things above being a son of God. That is why we have strife in church, pride in church, because all this leaven has filtered in. An organization invited me to speak at their marriage conference. And the evening was going to have a moderator. They spent a good 10 minutes introducing the moderator and his wife. I was so sick to my stomach, I almost left. By the time they finished introducing the guy, if you take 10 minutes to introduce a moderator, then how long would you take to introduce the speaker? And what time is left for Jesus to even come to the meeting? I pray that the word of resurrection will help the church come back to her senses. God first, God second,
God third. The lines must be so clear. When we gather together, we are all brothers and sisters in Christ before we are anything else. No inference of what we are in the world. No. I was speaking at a church and the glory wouldn't move. And I was wondering, Lord, what is going on? He said, so much pride. And I told them all to stand up. I said, you all go back out, checking your degrees and your money and all of that, and re-enter the sanctuary. Otherwise, God has left this place and will not return. So much pride. And then we commune with the Lord and eat the bread and the wine. And we're drinking damnation to ourselves. The exchange and the altar should be life, power, miracle, blessing, favor, deliverance, breakthroughs, open doors. Woo, hallelujah. Glory to God. When you make him number one, glory, God will invade your life and cause miracles to take place. We love you, beloved. We'll keep tracking on this powerful, powerful, miraculous way in this word God has given to us. God bless you. Bye-bye.